Welcome to EcoQuest 1, I'm your host lostwolfe. This is episode 2, we're about to go into the sea. Now here's one of the game's sort of sillier things. There's a maze here. It's not a particularly difficult maze, mind you, but it is a maze. And I've never really liked the design of mazes or maze-like things in general. It sort of feels like lazy design to me. But this one sort of signposts where you're supposed to go. So it's not too bad. I want to say I need to go up. Alright. And then maybe right. Maybe not. Okay. What I really should have done was, in my test playthrough of this game, I should have actually mapped the maze. But, I thought, oh well, it's not a particularly difficult maze. That won't be a problem. And look at us. I think this just takes me to the beginning. What I will say for this game, for a Sierra game, is that the backdrops are very, very beautiful. Although you can sort of see the lines where they scanned this in, unfortunately. And this is going to take me to the beginning. Yeah? Oh. No. There we go. Oh no, this is the beginning. Please don't turn back now, Adam. Hooray needs you. I wasn't turning back, sir. I was having technical difficulties. Let's try down, because we didn't do that yet. Try left. Actually, you know what we should do? I should maybe just follow the coral. There we go. Wow. She is beautiful, isn't she? Her name is Luria. My home. I think you need to talk to the Oracle. The Oracle of Luria can see into the future. If anyone could know what you should do to help the city, it'd be her. I'd better go see what's been going on since I left. I'll be at the fish apartments if you need me. Good luck, Adam. A long string that has no red shapes tied to it looks by. Adam thinks it looks familiar, but it's gone before he can remember where he's seen it before. That was obviously the balloon. Anyway, so, as I was saying yesterday, the conceit of this game is that there's all this stuff at the bottom of the ocean. Your job is to pick it up with the trash bag command. This is one of them. And yesterday I was saying that each of the pieces of trash has its own item description. So here's something like that. Holy HGTV. Some little bug dumped a boob tube in the ocean. Now you would think that Adam's bag couldn't manage that, but it can. Since the ancient Greeks didn't have modern plumbing, Adam guesses that the pipe is merely a result of more human littering. There's a sturdy steel cage lying on the ocean floor. It looks like it might have once been a bicycle basket. That boombox has boomed its last boom. Oh boy, okay. This is an old 80s term for a radio that no one really uses anymore. An old shopping cart lies rusting in the courtyard. Adam's heard of shopping carts being stolen from grocery store parking lots, but this is ridiculous. Okay. Fortunately for Adam, The shopping cart is collapsible. Adam stuffs it easily into his garbage bag. Adam transmits the radio into his garbage bag. One of Adam's teachers used to talk about trash on TV, but this television is trashy without even being turned on. Adam dumps it into his garbage bag. Adam ditches the pipe. Okay, so I think... No, there's still a little bit of trash over here. It looks like someone's thrown away a desk chair, the kind that rolls around on the floor. Adam's dad has one just like it at home. Of course, dad would never dispose of anything so thoughtlessly. Let's grab that. Adam wheels the desk chair into the twilight zone of his garbage bag. And I think that's the section we'll clean up. Oh, no. I see more. A deflated beach ball lies discarded in the courtyard. At least this is one piece of garbage that seems logical here, under the ocean. Let's go grab that. If Adam wants to stop the oogie green stuff, he'll have to find the source. The sad little beach ball, flat as yesterday's newspaper, sinks slowly into Adam's trash bag. Oh, that's the oogie stuff he was talking about. Let's look at that. Wisps of oogie green stuff occasionally float by. Adam doesn't know what it is, but he knows he doesn't want to get near it. It's doing a thing where it's telling us, oh, this is going to be relevant later. There's a statue of a Greek discus thrower in the courtyard. The Greeks started the first Olympics. Sorry, when I said I think I mentioned that everyone was Greek. The lady in the statue seems to have lost her mind. Her head is, elsewhere. We'll see it much, much later. Anyway, so this we do need, so we're going to pick that up. Adam picks up the steel cage, thinking that it might come in handy. And that certainly does. I think... Adam is swimming in a lowering courtyard. This must have been a city street. No, it's more like a fish highway. Sunken buildings, debris, and other remnants of a Grecian city surround the courtyard. The courtyard would be truly beautiful if not for the human garbage that litters the area. Have I not gotten everything? A really old tricycle, half disintegrated, lies childless and discarded in the courtyard. I did not get everything. Adam trashes the three-wheeler. Okay, I think I've gotten everything, but I'm not totally sure. Anyway, so it was talking about this here. To Adam's right is the majestic temple of Poseidon. A feeling of power surrounds the building. There's a beautiful bronze statue in front of the temple. Adam is swimming in front of a large and impressive bronze statue. The huge figure must be Poseidon, Greek god of the sea. His bronze eyes seem to look right through Adam. Poseidon is holding a bronze trident in his fist. There's another guy over here. The bronze servant figure is forever honoring the god of the sea. The servant's right hand is oddly cupped near his mouth, as though he was once holding something. But now it's missing. Let's try and take the trident. Adam pulls and pulls at the bronze trident, but Poseidon has it firmly in his grasp and is not ready to let go of it. But that's important to know. We do need to know that we need to get the trident. Let's swim this away. Okay, so there's a couple of things going on here. The first thing is, when I was doing my test playthrough of this, I didn't realize that this was actually just a wisp of grass, and I kept trying to clean it up, but that's all that really is, as you can see there. But that's neither here nor there. Let's look at this. A pedestal stands in the middle of the temple. On top of the pedestal is a large conch shell. Let's grab the conch shell. Adam takes the bronze conch shell. Adam is carrying a large bronze... let's try to say that three times. Large bronze conch shell. Conch shells have been valued for centuries because of the deep resonant sound they produce when blown. Is there anything in the conch shell? Adam would like to blow the mighty conch, but he can't take out his regulator. He would die. Oh, we haven't actually looked at this. The steel cage looks as though it might have once been a bicycle basket. Although it was dumped as trash, Adam thinks he might be able to find a new use for the cage. And there's a couple other things we can look at here. An odd carving of three large eyes dominates the center of the back wall of the temple. Oh, it isn't going to give me any sort of joy about this, is it? Three eyes, stare back. On the wall is a mosaic tile picture. It looks like the seawater has caused the cement around the tiles to weaken. And now the picture is scrambled. Okay, so remember when I said that we're not going to get 4 points for this game? This is why we're not going to get 4 points for this game. It has a help feature that will actually solve this, and that is sort of what I'm inclined to do, because this is a sliding puzzle, and they are ridiculous. But first, let's do something somewhat important. Okay, so I'm gonna try and swim a little upward so you can see it. But the servant here is holding his mouth up to something. And of course, the conch shell was sort of a thing that you could blow. And that would mean probably summoning Poseidon. So let's give that to the servant. Adam places the bronze shell into the cupped hands of the servant, keeping his fingers crossed that this will work. The bronze servant comes to life and puffs out his cheeks for a mighty blow. Poseidon has loosened his grip on the trident. So, let's grab the trident. Adam pulls on the bronze trident, and it slides easily from Poseidon's fist. Okay, now, the thing about the trident, the bronze trident has a large handle and three prongs on one end. The three prongs have pointed tips, is that we're going to need it for most of the rest of the game, so I'm not going to put it back, but you can if you want to. Let's head on inside here. Adam pushes one of the eyes. The eyes retract into the wall, but nothing happens. So you can do that, and this is the clue that you need three prongs over there. Too bad Adam can't press all three eyes at once, and for that you need Poseidon's trident. The trident pushes into the three eyes and the wall trembles. The panel slowly opens. A fish appears mysteriously from somewhere behind the panel. It must be the Oracle. The Oracle knows all life in the sea. Creature of man, I know not thee. Let's talk to the Oracle. My name is Adam. I came here with Dolphinius to help save the kingdom. What can I do to help? A prophecy from an ancient year spoke of days of death and fear. A human boy, kind and brave, would the kingdom of Illyria save. Three riddles will your soul reveal. Use your heart, the truth to feel. The riddle symbols must be whole. The soul of the mosaic is your goal. On the wall is a mosaic tile picture. It looks... Oh, okay. So anyway, this is a standard ye old tile puzzle. There's a space here, and what that means is that I can move this or this or this into the space, but not this or this, which means no diagonals. The idea, of course, is to form a coherent picture, and the coherent picture is going to be basically, it looks like a dog and a man, and I'm terrible at these, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to fast forward. Well, I'm not even going to fast forward. I'm just going to edit away my shame, and you're going to see the end result where I've hit help a bunch of times. I'm going to show you what it looks like when I hit help once, and at the end, we will have a completed picture. So, here goes me and my shame. I'll see you in about a minute or so. That's it. The mysterious mosaic is now fully revealed. And I don't think that's all the points that you can get for doing that, of course, because it didn't actually solve it, but there you go. Three riddles will your soul reveal. Use your heart the truth to feel. So, showing you the picture, here's the first riddle to master. From the picture, choose an answer. Whose march of progress dooms us all? Lives aloof to nature's call. Before he walks, he must learn to crawl, and be a friend to great and small. So, this is obviously man. In the picture here, Adam is swimming in the Temple of Poseidon. Okay, so in this picture, we have a sort of a shield with a heart in it. We have a dog here. We have man who's holding a sword. Sorry, there's the shield. That's just his heart. So we're going to point to man because that's what answers the riddle. I believe that answers the riddle. Is the answer man? The riddle, have you answered true? A vision I will grant to you. Once there was a great whale king whose tail kept off all poisonous things. Like under glass, we lived so free from all with which man kills the sea. That's obviously Cetus. This is Illyria, and he is in his kingdom. Here's the second you must master. From the picture, choose an answer. What glides like a bird, but does not fly, lives and plays neath the emerald sky, feels the hook's pain, but cannot cry, has no voice to question why? It is not obvious, but there's a fish there. I think it's a fish. Is the answer fish? The riddle of your answer true, a vision I will grant to you. And so an innocent shall fall, and become the stalker of us all. Mutated by a glowing breeze, man makes a murderer of the seas. He's obviously killer whales, something bad has happened to them, and they are doing terrible things. Here's the third and last to master. From the picture, choose an answer. What reaches out to those in need? Here's the call of those who bleed. Never blindly takes in greed, is a friend in word and deed. And that, I believe, is heart. Is the answer love? The riddle you have answered true, a vision I will grant to you. A mighty king was led astray, tricked and lured into harm's way. With all his strength, he cannot free himself from man's machinery. Our destiny lies with he, foretold within the prophecy. And obviously something terrible happened to Cetus. We got a boat there. That's probably Cetus and something terrible happening to him. The prophecy says a child of man might help save Illyria. Could that be me? Your answers show that you can see the carelessness that haunts the seas. But the citizens must give their trust to you alone. Win them you must. This sign of trust bring back to me, and you shall have the prophecy. And off the oracle goes. Okay, so we need to head out of here. You met the Oracle, huh? What'd she say, Adam? What'd she say? She says I should find a sign of trust from the citizens. What could she mean, Del? A sign of trust, eh? Beats me. Maybe you should talk to the city's mayor and the guardian of the greens. If you can find them, that is. I've seen hardly anyone since I've been back. It is kind of creepy. Where do you think I should look for the mayor and the guardian of the greens? Somewhere indoors. I'll meet you back at the fish apartments later. Come by if you can't find who you're looking for. Let's go left first. In the distance, small deserted ruins of this once great city lie disintegrating in the seawater. The royal gardens were once full of splendor, but the plants have fallen prey to dioxin and other poisons in the water. Even little bits of life that still remain are pale and sickly. Of course, dioxin is a toxin, and it's doing a number on everything here. There's a whole bunch of things underground that we can collect with our garbage bag. There's a broken empty pot littering the royal gardens. Some lady must be looking really hard for a purse, because there's one just lying here. A beat-up, bent-up bicycle wheel lies alone on the garden's floor. That spray bottle is clearly no use under the sea. There's an old fishing line on the ground. It looks like what the one that got away with. An old tire sunk to the bottom of the sea. My land vehicle's tire is in the ocean. Adam will never know. An entire six-pack of sodas found its way to the bottom of the sea. Too bad fish don't like carbonated drinks. I think that's all the trash. So let's clean up, of course. Thing number one to do on every screen that we encounter. Adam decides to be nice and clean up the old pot. Oh, sorry. Adam rides the wheel into the trash. I was actually aiming for the purse, but that's fine. Adam snatches the purse and bags it. Adam puts a spritz on the spray bottle. Adam slowly slips the sheet into the sack. Oh, I didn't notice that. Well, it's good that we found it. Adam slams the soda down his garbage bag. Adam reels in the old fishing line. Adam wheels rubber to a permanent parking spot. I think that's all the trash in this area. Okay, so let's have a look at the statue. A large statue of a whale made entirely from coral takes a place of honor in the middle of the garden. The coral is coated with oil and clearly dying. This kind of damage is a result of oil spills and ship bulge dumping. The lighter part of the oil evaporates. What's left sinks, ending up as a thick tar that coats the ocean floor. A huge, beautiful shell lies in front of the whale statue. One of the things that we can do something about is the oil here. Don't worry, Carl. This is fertilizer solution from my dad's lab. I'm not sure it will help you, but without it, you'll die for sure. Adam carefully pours the fertilizer solution over the whale-shaped coral. He puts the empty flask into his garbage bag. The oil begins to dissolve. It's working. Ouch. What are you doing to my coal, child? Oops. I just put some solution on the coal that will create bacteria to eat up the oil. What do you mean to help? I felt so sorry for the poor coral. A human? Feeling sympathy for the creatures of the sea? Why, you're right. The oil is dissolving. What is your name then, magic one? My name is Adam, but it's not magic, just science. Who are you? I'm the guardian of the greens, but you can call me Demeter. Again, a wonderful name. It is my job to tend the oil gardens and ensure that the city has plenty of plants to eat, but as you can see, my garden is all but dead. What will you do when the plants are gone? We shall be forced to leave Illuria or die here. I'm not sure which is the worst fate. If only Cetus was here, were here. The coal misses him so. You know, they shaped themselves like this in an homage to him. If only I knew Cetus was somewhere safe, I could be content with this lot. It should be homage, sorry. Well, I came in with Alphinius, but trying to help the city, and maybe find Cetus. You would do that, human child? Perhaps that's just what we need. Someone who knows the mysteries of man and the poisons he puts into the sea. Here, take this with you. What is this? It is the last of my healing potion. It has a great power to heal. I used to make it from over 30 rare sea plants, but most of them are extinct now, killed off by poisons. There will be no more potion. The potion does not work on my poor garden. Perhaps you will find a good use for it on your quest to save the city. Thank you for this gift, Demeter. Use it wisely, human child, and may Poseidon watch over you. Okay, something fell there. A glop of tar has fallen from the coal. Something white is sticking up out of the tar. I don't know. Well, Adam is sort of in the way. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get that like that. Just grab it here. Adam picks the shell up from the tar. Ick, it's a nice roomy shell, but it won't be much use covered with tar like that. Oh, I can't solve that problem quite yet. There are other things I need before I can do that. I was getting ahead of myself. Okay, so... let's... get out of here. I think I've cleaned up everything I need to clean up. Oh no, an old vegetable can has been ditched. Broccoli. And there's another thing here. There's an old brown shoe in the ground. It looks like the nerd variety of polyester plastic shoe. Ah, the 80s. When nerd was still an insult. Adam carefully picks up the brown shoe and does the world a favor by throwing it away. Although this game was made in the 90s, but you know. With great relief, Adam cans the can of broccoli. Good job! Adam may not be able to reverse all the damage in the plants of the royal gardens, but at least he's removed all the visible litter. Oh, okay. It will actually tell me when I've done everything. Which means that I probably haven't done everything here. I don't know what I'm missing. I'll probably have to just look that up. Anyway, let's head this way. Oh, is it? Oh. I'm gonna absolutely have to do that, aren't I? Halt! Who dares enter the chambers of the great senator? The booming voice seems to come from nowhere. The only thing that we can see that's ahead is this or this. But this looks more conspicuous than this, so let's talk to this. But seeing no one in the room, Adam tentatively calls out, who are you?
I am the great senator. Tremble before me.
Okay, I'm Adam. Delphinius brought me here to help.
Adam? I know of no Illyrians named Adam. Eek? You're human? A son of man here? Where's that blasted blubber farm of a whale?
What whale? You mean Cetus?
Of course, Cetus. But I didn't say blasted blubber farm of a whale. Not me. I never said that.
Cool.
Benevolent, impressively large whale is what I actually said. Great Cetus maketh the food plentiful, and the city pure. He banishes the sharks, and conger alike us. He maketh the water clear, and filtereth the yucky stuff. Oh, and he maketh us cleanseth behind our gills.
But Cetus is missing.
I know that, alas, poor Illyria. Cetus has vanished for, lo, many days. Cetus is gone, only Poseidon knows where he is hitherto. But fear not, for the great senator will personally see to it. That Illyria great kingdom survives.
How will you replace Cetus, great senator? Things look a mess to me. Maybe I could help.
Help? You? The great senator needs no help. The great senator has not acted, because he is still pondering the situation. If you're so smart, try solving the challenge of the columns.
What challenge of the columns?
Find the one that turns no other. Make it match its right-hand brother. Repeat until all nine are done. And the council's favor, you'll have won. And now I'll answer no more questions, human boy. The great senator will now stay silent and silently ponder.
So what he's referring to is these columns over here. We have to essentially match up the left with the right-hand side. So if you look over here, there's a human child there, and a human child there. And if we turn these... Whoa, the column pieces move. I wonder what order I should put them in. We've got to get them to line up. So, like there, that's wavy. The column piece locks into place. Now I just the corresponding column piece on the right side of the council chambers. This is also wavy, so let's do this. Okay, I'm not going to get that because this is going to move. Let's see if we can match this one up. Actually, let's try and do this from left to right. Nope. There we go, the column piece locked into place. And again, this is just a mirror of... Oh, I'm looking at it wrong. Oh god, that was terrible. This one and this one line up. I was trying to line this one with this one. And that was futile. Okay, so I need to get that. Oh. The columns are now perfectly aligned. Adams doesn't want to mess with perfection. If you get something right, like this one here, it's now correct. Because it matches this one. I can't mess that one with it anymore. There we go, the column piece locks into place. This is rotating this one. No. There we go. I like this puzzle a tiny bit better than I like the sliding mosaic tile puzzle. But only a little bit more. Okay, so this whole column is now basically correct. This one's correct. let's mess with this one. There we go. Last column place, a piece shifts into place. Adam feels the water tremble. The room shakes as the building settles down on the columns. The gold mask is knocked from the wall. A dazed hermit crab stumbles forth from the fallen mask.
Boo-hoo. Oh, boo-hoo.
I can't handle it. I can't. So, I tried, but no one will listen to me. No one cares.
Oh, boo. Boo-hoo.
Who are you? I'm the great senator. I mean, I'm a nobody. Boo-hoo, I'm a failure. Boo-hoo, dee-hoo. Well, why were you hiding in a mask? My name is Superfluous. Also a great name. I've always been the mayor, but I never actually had to do anything. She just took care of it all, you see. Now he's gone and I ought to do something, but I don't know what. Oh gosh, you need to call a meeting or something. Get everyone to help. Oh, they won't listen. Why do you think I pretended to be the great senator? They might have respected him, but no, they're all huddled in their homes, scared. They won't come out for a meeting. Not that I can blame them. Here I sit with a shawl so tight I'm about to burst, and I'm too scared to go out and find a new one. Bahaha. Well, maybe I can get the citizens to come out. Why should they listen to you, a human boy? Why, I don't even trust you. No, sorry. I don't think it would work. It would be nice if it could, though. Goodbye now. I must go back to my pondering. Okay, so this is our next job. We need to get the senator, the great senator, to trust us. And to do that, we're going to have to get the fish to the meeting hall. And that's a thing that we're going to tackle tomorrow. That's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, lostwolfe. This has been episode 2 of EcoQuest for 0 December. I hope that you're enjoying this as much as I'm enjoying playing it for you. Have a wonderful evening. And good night for now, folks.